Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're looking at placing type on a circle in Illustrator. For this project, I'll be using a couple of Design Cuts assets, so let's go and have a look and see what I'll be using. I'll be using a circle from the Mandela's logo creator. Inside this collection are a number of Mandela circles, and we'll be using one of those to illustrate our quote. And I'll also be using a font. The font I'm using is Blessed Script Font by Blessed Print. It's just a beautiful script for this project. So back in Illustrator, I already have my Mandela Circles file open. I'm going to create a file we'll be working in, so I'll choose File New. I'm going to create one 1200 by 1200 pixels in size. I happen to be working in RGB color. I'll click Create. It doesn't really matter how big your image is. I'll go back to the Mandela circles and select the circle I want to use, which is this one here. I'll copy it, and I'm just using a keyboard command, Control or Command C, and I'll paste it with Control or Command V, and then size it. When I resize this particular shape, you'll notice that the stroke weight gets much heavier. That's a result of an Illustrator preference. I've got mine set to scale strokes and effects. So if I go to Edit and Preferences, which of course on a Mac would be Illustrator and then Preferences, and go to General, I've got scale strokes and effects selected, which is why the stroke is becoming thicker the larger that this circle becomes. If yours doesn't change, it's because you don't have that setting set. So I'm going to make my circle about how big I want it to be and then select it, and I'm going to bring down the stroke weight because I think it's a little bit thick for what I want. Let's try edit about 3. Next, I'll add a couple of circles that I'll be using for my type. I'll go to the ellipse tool, hold the shift key as I drag out a circle, and then to reposition the circle, I'll hold down the space bar because that allows me to move the circle while I'm still drawing it. Now, I'm not going to get the positioning perfect, and that doesn't matter because what I'm going to do is make another one of these circles exactly the same as this one, then we'll center everything. So I'll select the circle, choose Edit Copy to make a duplicate of it, and then Edit Paste in place so that the two circles are exactly on top of each other. To center everything, I will select all of these pieces and then click Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center. And now everything is nicely centered and we're ready to go ahead and add our text. Before I get started with the text, let's go to the layers panel. I'm just going to make my thumbnails a little bit bigger so it's more easy for you to see them. We've got a group which are these leaves, and I'll lock that down because I don't want it to move. And I've got two ellipses or two circles, one on top of the other. I'm going to turn one off and lock it down so it won't move. So there's only one that's selectable and that we can work with right now. I've created two circles because I want a quote to go across the top of this shape, and then I want the author of the quote's name to be at the bottom. And because these two pieces of text will be totally separate, and because each of these circles is going to be sacrificed as we add text to it, I need two circles to place these two elements of text. If you wanted the circle as well, then you'll always need to make an extra copy of the circle because, as I said, these circles are going to be sacrificed in the process. Now we'll choose the Type on a Path tool. When you're working with a closed shape, such as a circle, you need to select Type on a Path. If you were just working, for example, on a wiggly line, you could use the Type tool, and as soon as you get near that line, Illustrator's going to assume that you want to do type on a path. But because there are two things that you could do with a circle, one is to use it as an area type, in other words, fill it with text, and one is to use the path itself, you need to be more careful about which option you choose. So I'll choose type on a path, and I'll click on the path to select it, and you can see that the path has now been sacrificed, and we've got a little I-beam pointer in here indicating that that's where our text is going to be placed. Now I have the type of my quote in a Word document, so I'll just select it and press Control or Command C. I'll go back to my Illustrator file and I'll press Control or Command V to paste in my text. Now I'll select my text, and you can use the regular selection tools to do that. I'm holding down the Shift key and using the left arrow key to move forward through my text, and I'm adding the Control or Command key to jump one word at a time. I'll increase the type point size. Now, I'm not using the font that I want to use yet, so I'm not 100% sure how big I want it to be, but I'm going to sort of settle for 50 points at this stage. If you hold the Shift key as you press the up arrow, you'll go up 10 points at a time. If you just press the up arrow key, you'll go up 1 point at a time. And we'll go and select the font we will be using. It's Blessed Script Regular. So I'm thinking that the font size is pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. But of course, the text is not nicely aligned around this circle. It should start probably somewhere around here. So let's have a look at how we move text around a circle, because this is the point that often sends people quite crazy, because it really isn't as easy as it should be. So let's zoom in a little bit so that we can see things just a little bit more clearly. When you're trying to arrange text around a circle, once you've got your text in and you just want to start moving it, then you're going to use the selection tool. And I'll click to select the path that we're working on. And there are three indicators here that we need to pay attention to. One is a bar over here, and then there are two little boxes here with lines through them. And these are the beginning and end of the text. And right now, the beginning and end of the text are pretty much in the same position. So what Illustrator is saying is your text can go all the way around, and it could go all the way around to here. But as soon as you get to this point, if it doesn't fit, it's not going to be overlapped. Well, we want to split this because we want to bring the beginning of the text down here, which means that we need to move the end of the text a little bit. So this one's going to be the end of the text, because when I hover over it, the mouse pointer turns to a black arrow, and underneath at the bottom right corner of the mouse pointer is a vertical bar with an arrow that points to the left. That's the end text icon. Until you see that on the screen, don't click, don't do anything, because you're just guaranteeing that disaster is about to strike. If you do click and drag and things go really haywire, just press Control or Command Z to undo. But what you're looking for is this mouse pointer. As soon as you've got that, then you can click and drag. And this is the end of the text, and I'm going to take it back to probably about here. And the text has now been cut off, and the little box has gone red with a plus, and that's telling me that there is more type here than Illustrator can possibly show me, because I just said that you can't go any further with your text than here. That's fine right now, because what I want to do is drag the beginning down here, and when I drag the beginning down, this word that's missing is going to reappear. Now the indicator here, the mouse pointer, is another black arrow. This time the indicator at the bottom right corner of the mouse pointer is again a vertical bar, but the arrow points to the right. That tells you that it's the beginning marker. Don't do anything till you see it. As soon as you do see it, you can pick it up and start moving things. And you can see that the word over on the right just reappeared. Now I'd like to get my text pretty well lined up, so let's choose View and then Rulers and choose Show Rulers. From here, I can drag a guide into my document, and I'm just going to place it roughly halfway between this mark here and this mark here. In other words, where I need to pull this one down to, and this one will go up here, and it will be roughly equal. I'm not going to be overly fussy, but I do want it to be a little more equal than it is right now, a bit more even. So again, I'm looking for that mark. I'm not going to do anything until I see that mouse pointer. When I see it, I can just pull my text down a little bit, not quite far enough. And that's looking really, really good. So I can grab my guide and just delete that. I'll just press delete. So I've got the first piece of text in place, but I can't put my author of my quote down here, because you can't put two pieces of text on a single line. So let's lock that one down. Let's make the second line visible. Let's go and get the Type on a Path tool. And I'm going to click here because this is where I want to start my author's name, and it's Albert Camus. So let's just copy that and let's paste it. Well, it's going in all the wrong directions, but that's fine because we know exactly what to do with it. We're going to hover until we see the indicators that we're looking for. This is the end of the type, and this one is the beginning of the type. Just watch for those arrows, even if it seems counterintuitive. The one that points to the left is always the end of the type. The one that points to the right is always the beginning of the type. Now with this piece of type, it would make better sense if we could read Albert Camus, and reading Albert Camus is going to require us to flip the text across the path. And that's where this middle bar comes in. Now this middle bar is not always in the middle. It can appear in all sorts of places depending on what you've done with your type, but you're looking for a bar that is just a bar. It doesn't have any box on it, and when you hover over it in the correct position, you'll see again you get a bar and an arrow, but this time the arrow is going to point towards the center of the circle, and it is a flip option, so you can use it to flip the text across the circle. Again, I'm going to bring my guide down. I think my type is a little bit too big here, so let me just go in and select it and just change the font size down. And again, to move it around, we're going to need to pick up this beginning marker because that's the one that actually moves the text. The one at the end just marks out where the text can finish. So just making sure that I've got the right mouse pointer showing. That's telling me that the text is actually going to move. Once I've finished with this, I can just delete my guide. Now, one of the really nice things about the font that I've chosen to use here is that it has glyphs in the font. So I'm going to remove the letter S and I'm going to choose an alternate S style. And when I do that in later versions of Illustrator, you'll see that the alternatives pop up underneath the letter and I can select the one I want to use. Now, if that doesn't happen for you, you can always go to Window and then Type and Glyphs, and you can select your glyph character from the list of glyphs that's visible on the screen. I like to use those glyphs where I can, where there are some interesting characters that I could use. Now, a finishing touch for this particular project will be to add a new layer. I'm going to move this new layer underneath the original layer, and I'm going to lock down the original layer because what I want to do is to paint some colors underneath the leaves here. And I'll do that with the blob brush. So I'll click on the blob brush and I'll go and select a color to use. So I'm going to use some sort of autumn or fall sorts of colors, and I'll start painting over the leaves. As soon as I've finished painting with the blob brush, you'll notice that the color disappears and appears underneath the leaves. That's because I'm painting on to a layer that is underneath the leaf layer. Once you've applied paint like this, if you need to remove any, then you can go to the eraser tool. Because I locked down that top leaf layer, I'm not going to be erasing anything from the actual leaves themselves, just the paintwork that I've applied to them. So you can neaten it up if you want to. But that is our finished project. We've created text on a circle. We've done it twice because we needed to have text going in two different directions for this project. I hope that you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.